Hey everyone, in this video we are going to learn how to detect contours in a video file which has objects or multiple objects. So contours can be explained simply as a curve joining all the continuous points having same color or intensity. It is a useful tool for shape analysis and object detection and recognition. So before starting with the project, make sure you hit the subscribe button and give a thumbs up at the end. So let's create a new file. I'll go in file and new, and I'll create a Python file. Let's say I'll give a name as contour. So first we'll see how to load a video file in OpenCV. So we will be needing OpenCV library, import CV2. Now to access a video from your computer, create a variable name capcap, or it can be any variable you want, and write CV2 dot video capture. And inside the video capture, in single quote, write your file name, since I have a file named ball2.mp4. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll create a while loop while it is true. So create two variable, one name success and one name frame, and I need to read this variable. So I'll write capcap.read. Basically, we all know that videos are basically motion, images in motion. So first frame will come in this variable and it will be stored in this frame. Second frame will again come in this variable and it will be stored in this variable. So our final variable is frame. So to see that video, write cv2.imshow. Give the window name. I'm giving as input. You can give any name you want, and the name of your variable frame, and give a delay of 1 millisecond. cv2.waitKey1. So if I execute this code. So the video file is too large. What I need to do is I need to reduce the size of my output window. So I'll again take the same variable named frame and I'll resize it. To resize, write cv2.resize, pass the frame which you want to resize, comma, the width and the height. I'm giving as 500 pixels, comma 500 pixels. Now if you execute this code, so here is our output window. The input which I have written over here is nothing but this window name. Okay. So now I will detect contours on the object which is in this video, that is basketball and football and rugby. So to detect contours, what we need to do is first we need to convert our colored video into a binary video. It means only black and white. So we will apply Kenny algorithm. And before applying Kenny algorithm, we need to create track bars. So to create track bars, I'll create a window name cv2.namedWindow and I'll give it name track bars. Again, I have uploaded a video on track bars, so you can check it out. I will post the link in description. cv2.createTrackBar. So we will be creating two track bars, one for lower value and one for upper value. So lower, comma, the window name. So I want this track bar name lower on this window. So I'll copy this and paste it over here. And I will start my track bar from 0 and it should go up to 255. And I need to create one more variable. I need to pass one more argument over here. So for that, what I'll do, I'll create a function named nothing. Def nothing. Basically, it's of no use. So we will directly simply just pass the value over here. So nothing. So if I execute this code, you will see that we will have one track bar over here. So it, the track bar window name is track bars. Track bar name is lower. It starts from 0 and it goes till 255. Okay. Similarly, I'll create one more track bar name upper. So cv2.createTrackBar. Again, you can give any name you want over here and give a name track bar. But be specific over here. If you have given a name track bus, so the name over here should be exactly same. Comma 0, comma 255, comma again our variable, nothing. So now if I execute, I will have two track bus. Now what I need to do is I need to use this value somewhere. Okay, so I need to retrieve these values from my track bus. So to retrieve these values, I'll go in while loop. And over here, I'll retrieve the values. Okay. So to retrieve the values, I'll create a variable name L is equals to CV dot get TRA CV2 dot sorry CV2 dot get. It will show CV2 dot get track bar position. In track bar position, you need to write the track bar name for which you want the value and the window name. So for L means lower, it means I will use this track bar name and the window name. Copy and paste it over here. Similarly, U means upper is equal to CV2 dot create, sorry, CV2 dot get track bar position, write upper, comma, write track bars. Again, make sure the names are same. It means if you have written upper and U is capital, then over here also the U should be capital. Now if I simply print L and U, I should get my values. So if I print L and U and execute this code. So as you can see in the window, command window below, if I'm changing the values, I am getting those values. So now I will use these values to apply in Kenny algorithm. So what does Kenny algorithm do? Basically, it will detect edges in my input video or image. So to apply Kenny algorithm, it's very simple. Basically, what you need to do is create a variable. Let's say I create a variable named Kenny itself equals to CV2 dot capital CANNY Kenny. Now pass the image or the file on which you want to apply this algorithm. I want to apply this algorithm on my frame. So copy this and paste it over here. Sorry. I'll write frame, comma. It is asking me for threshold 1. Threshold 1 is my L and threshold 2 is my U. Okay. So what we'll do, we'll display the Kenny CV2.imshow. I am writing it as binary video. You can give any name you want, comma. So Kenny, because our binary video is on, it's been stored in this variable. Okay, so now if I execute this code, so as you can see, this is our binary video. Okay, so as you can see, it is detecting edges in the video. As and I adjust these values, so you can see it is detecting edges. So I need to adjust in such a way that there are less that there is less disturbance in my video. So I'll adjust it. Okay. So I guess this is proper. It is perfectly detecting my edges in all the objects in my image. So 82 and 223 is the perfect value. Again, if you don't understand this Kenny algorithm, I have a separate video on this. You can check it out. Okay. So I have successfully detected edges on my input video. Now I will draw contours on that edges, which will reflect in my input video. So to apply contours, what you need to do is I'll comment over here, contours. So there are two methods. One to find the contour and second is to draw the contours. So first we'll find the contours. So to find the contour, I'm creating three variables name I contours, contours, and let's say hierarchy. Again, you can give any name you want over here. I am just giving these three variables. I'll explain what is these three variables. Write cv2 dot find contours. So in contours, you need to pass the binary image. So my binary image of video is this. Well, take this and I'll post this over here. Kenny, comma, It is asking me mode. So there are different modes to detect contours in a video or image. So we are going to use cv2.retrieval tree method and method. So the method, there are many methods like cv2.writeChain. So chain approx, none, chain approx simple, and others. So chain approx will basically draw contours on all the edges, and simple will detect contours on specific points. So we'll use chain approx none. Now why these three variables? These three variables is because my canny image has been stored in this eye. These contours which had been detected will be stored in contours, and this function will be stored in hierarchy, this variable. It's like we are reading the file and it has been stored in frame. Similarly, the same thing is happening over here. Okay. Now I am using OpenCV library, which is not the latest. So I need these three values. If you are using the latest OpenCV library, just remove this first variable. Okay. Just remove this first variable. But as I am not using the latest library, I will use this method. Okay. So now what I'll do, I have found my contours. Okay, let's check if I am getting the output or not. So there is no output over here. So because we need to draw the contours. So to draw the contours, what we need to do, we'll write cv2.drawContours. Now I want to draw my contours on my input video, and my input video is nothing but frame, which has been stored in frame. Okay. The second argument which will ask is contours. So in cv.findContours, this function detect contours, and it stores in this variable. So I'll copy this variable and I'll post it over here. I'll keep it as -1 only, because I need all the lines to be drawn. It basically fills the contour, comma color. As OpenCV takes color input as B, G, and R, so if I need my contour drawn on with color blue, I'll write 255 blue, green 0, red 0, and thickness I'll give as 3. Let's check if this is working. If I execute this code, okay, so as you can see, I have this contours on my original image. Okay, now if I change the values, wait, I'll shift it over here. So now if I change the values, as you can see, I can clearly see my contours. Okay, so you need to adjust in such a way that there is less disturbance. That's why we use track bars. It becomes easy to change the values instead of doing it manually. Okay, so I'll increase this upper bound a bit more. And I guess this is perfect. It might happen that video is lagging, because while recording the video might lag because the video is of high quality. Okay. Otherwise it will run smoothly. Okay. So yeah. So as you can see, this is my output. Okay. Now it will throw an error at the end, because the duration of my video is over. Okay. If your duration is let's say 5 seconds, then it will automatically terminate. So in that case, you need to again run your program. Okay, so I'll again show you over here. So if I change the values somewhat over this thing, so as you can see, this is my video in which I have successfully detected my contours. Okay, you can also put the text on your input video, such as, let's say I want to write a text, so I'll write cv2.put text. Okay, on which file you want your text? I want my text on my input frame, that is frame itself. So copy and paste, comma. It is asking what text I want, so I want contour detection. It should print contour detection in quotes. Okay, because it's a string. Origin, so it should start from, let's say, center, so we'll take 200 comma 100. Okay, font scale I'll give as -1 straight. If you give -1, it will flip. Okay, color, so color I'll take as red, so blue 0, green 0, reddish 255, and thickness I'll give as 3. I guess we are missing something. Okay, we are missing font face. Okay, so after the origin should come in brackets because it's a tuple. Okay, so after origin I need to put font face, means like in Microsoft Word we have Calibri and other fonts. So similarly OpenCV has some pre-installed fonts. So write CV2.font, Hershey Complex, scale as 1, color as red, 0, 0, 255, and thickness as 3. Let's check what it is displaying. Okay, so here is our contour detection. If I change these values, okay, so I guess I need to shift it a bit left and a bit upward. So I'll remember this value 71 and 204. So I'll directly, instead of using variables, I'll write 71, 204. So no need to change track bar because I have got the values now, correct? So I need to shift it behind 150 and I need to take it upward, that is I'll take as 50. So this is my contour detection algorithm. So we have successfully drawn contours on the edges in the objects, like object is football, rugby and basketball. Similarly, you can apply this algorithm to any shape, any object you want, and you can also detect these shapes using by finding the areas, finding the parameters, which you will see in next videos. So I hope you all like this video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and don't forget to like. Thank you.